Hi everyone, for those of you who have followed my 30 Faces in 30 Days series back in January, I mentioned to you at the end of my challenge that there were other portraits that I wanted to paint, and it was mostly watercolor portraits. I didn't make any, and I really wanted to continue working on my Paul Dark series. And for those of you who don't know what Paul Dark is, it's a TV show, it's a period drama. And back in 2018, I started painting all the main characters, but I had only painted three, and I wanted to continue this series. So today I'm painting number four, and I'm using Arche paper. It's 140 pounds, and it's cold press. And I'm also using my limited skin tone palette. I basically poured the colors I wanted in half pans, and I arranged them in a little mint tin. So I have some Raw Sienna by Danielle Smith, Venetian Red by Kaur, Ultramarine Blue by M. Graham, Quinacridone Red by M. Graham, Quinacridone Gold by Kaur, Quinacridone Burnt Orange by Danielle Smith, Van Dyke Brown by Kaur, Quinacridone Violet by M. Graham, and Transparent Pyrrole, I don't know if it's Pyrrole Pyrrole, Orange by Kaur. So I did not use all of them, but what I usually start doing is making very light washes of most of these colors, and then I mix them together as I need them. I'm usually using some red and yellow for the skin tone. And so I often have the Raw Sienna mixed with either Venetian Red or Quinacridone Gold. Sometimes when the skin tone is a little bit more pinkish, I use the Quinacridone Red. For my shadows, I add a little bit of Ultramarine Blue or Quinacridone Violet, depending again on the skin tone, what I see, what I observe on the reference photo. I might even mix it a bit with a Van Dyke Brown. And in some brighter areas, then I might use more of the Quinacridone Gold to make the skin shine more. And I don't really have a particular way of painting it. It's really what I observe, and I really go with the flow, basically. With this portrait, I had a hard time for some reason, because the three previous portraits, what I did was trying to not blend my strokes too much. I wanted them to be quicker and not necessarily blend them, so I didn't mind showing the brush strokes, basically. And I think because of all the portraits that I recently made that were a lot softer, and maybe I used a different paper too, and then I used ink as well, I ended up taking the habit of blending all my strokes. And that's what I started by doing with this portrait. So I applied some paint on the paper, and then I rinsed my brush, dabbed it on a paper towel, and then smoothed it out to even it out so that there was no hard edges. You'll see with my other portraits that I do have hard edges, and I really don't mind them. I kind of like it. I do like it soft like this as well, but that's not what I meant to do. So halfway through my painting, I realized what I was doing, and I started changing a little bit. So yeah, I struggled a little bit with this painting, and I think that in the end, it doesn't have as much charm as the other ones that I painted, but it's still pretty. It resembles the actress, but it's not as good as I wanted it to be. I know, perfection. Ugh. For the lips, I mostly used some Quinacridone Violet mixed with Venetian Red, and it gave me a pretty natural color, which I often use for lips. I tried to be careful with the teeth because they're usually not white when you look at them on a photo. So I used some Ultramarine Blue, a little bit of Ultramarine Blue, to add a little shadow to them. For the hair, I first used a wash of Van Dyke Brown. I let it dry, and then I made a dark mix of Van Dyke Brown and Ultramarine Blue. I do not have any black or Payne's Gray in my palette, so I need to find a way to make that black. So I often use Ultramarine Blue and Burnt Umber to make a nice warm black, and I don't have Burnt Umber in my palette either, so that's why I use the Van Dyke Brown instead. Depending on how much blue or how much Van Dyke Brown you add, your black will be darker or not. So I did a couple layers of that, and then I realized that I did a terrible job. I really didn't like it. So when the hair was dry, I ended up adding another layer of Van Dyke Brown by itself. And I think it tied everything together. And all the lines that I made for the highlights don't look as fake as it was before. So all in all, even though I just painted and drew a bunch of portraits, I kind of felt rusty with this. Probably this style in particular, trying to be consistent in my series of Poldark characters. I don't know, but it felt weird. And I had just made a painting of the portrait of Frankie. I'll put a link. And I used Fabriano paper for that one. And somehow it felt easier to use that paper rather than the Arche paper. I think the Arche paper is a little bit rougher. I don't know, maybe I should continue making my watercolor portraits on the Fabriano paper instead of the Arche paper. I'll have to compare these two a bit more, see what I like them best for. So anyway, just one thing I forgot to say, for my brushes, I used the Princeton Velvet Touch brushes, which I really like. And I think that's it. Thank you all for stopping by. If you like this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up. And if you're brand new here, please consider subscribing to this channel. And remember to click on the little bell next to the subscribe button so you can see when I upload new videos. Have a wonderful day, everyone. I'll see you soon with another video. Bye-bye. Thank you.